Republicans and Democrats disagree about practically everything. But there's one thing that both sides seem to agree on.
Israel.
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 Every 4 years, presidential candidates make a point to show how much they support Israel. They emphasize the strong bonds between the two countries in terms of history, bilateral trade, and strategic alliances. It's true each president has enacted pretty different policies toward Israel. George Bush Sr. had a tumultuous relationship with the Jewish state. Bill Clinton and George W. Bush struck close friendships with their prime minister counterparts. Barack Obama didn't always see eye to eye with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, while Donald Trump usually does. Yet despite these differences, every president, Democrat or Republican, has fundamentally supported Israel, in office and on the campaign trail. So if presidential races are all about distinguishing yourself from your opponent, why do all these candidates sound more or less the same when it comes to Israel? It might be surprising to learn that the United States and Israel haven't always been close allies. In the mid-1950s, during the height of the Cold War, President Dwight Eisenhower didn't really care about the Jewish state. His focus was on the newly independent Arab countries, which he worried would be scooped up by the Soviet Union. During the Suez Crisis of 1956, Britain, France, and Israel formed an alliance against the most influential Arab country, Egypt, who found itself in the middle of a global tug of war. Eisenhower decided to condemn his country's Western allies and side with Egypt instead. But even after Britain, France, and Israel backed down, Egypt sided with the Soviets anyway, and the USSR became a dominant power in the Middle East. Years later, Eisenhower supposedly called this one of his biggest regrets as president. JFK supported Israel more than Eisenhower, and became the first US president to sell weapons to Israel. But it wasn't until Israel won the Six-Day War in 1967 that the U.S. realized what a powerful ally the little country could be. By the 70s, it was obvious that the United States and Israel shared more than just a Cold War enemy. The two countries were built on very similar values. Both were democracies that valued freedom of speech and equality before the law. Both countries still struggle with actualizing these ideals, but they're clearly on the same side when compared to the world's non-democratic alternatives. Around this time, a new political movement arose in America: Christian Zionism. Most evangelical Christians believe that Jews must return to Israel in order to fulfill a biblical prophecy bringing about the return of Jesus. In 1975, a Pentecostal minister laid the groundwork for what would become the nation's biggest pro-Israel lobby, Christians United for Israel. Another pro-Israel lobby, the American Israel Public Affairs Committee, or AIPAC, had been around since 1963. But it wasn't until the 1980s that its campaigns began influencing local elections, mostly because the government, and for the first time, a majority of American voters, had begun to realize the value of America's alliance with Israel. Around this same time, the U.S. government started to formalize its military relationship with Israel. Ronald Reagan explicitly talked up Israel's qualitative military edge, ensuring Israel would always have better defense technology than its regional neighbors. These advancements were incremental. The big shift came in the new millennium, 9/11 and Bush's war on terror. If America had one ally who understood self-defense against terrorism, it was Israel. All this brings us to the main reason Israel has become a bipartisan campaign tactic. If there is anything that politicians care about during an election year, it's public opinion. Every poll since the 80s has shown that the majority of Americans have a favorable view of Israel, rarely dipping below 50%. In a 2019 Gallup poll, American sympathies towards the Jewish state in relation to the Israeli-Palestinian conflict dropped to its lowest point in a decade, but even that was 59%. Support for Israel is one subject presidential candidates can safely campaign on. After decades of complex history built on public support, foreign policy alignment, religious interests, and defense goals, boosting the Jewish state remains a popular bipartisan strategy in American politics. Peace in the Middle East has become the foreign policy holy grail for American presidents. Obviously, it would be a feather in any president's cap, a feather about the size of a Nobel Peace Prize, but it would also strengthen the deep, fundamental, and constantly growing bond shared by Israel and the United States. Thanks for watching! If you like this video, consider subscribing. And if you have a topic you want us to tackle in an upcoming video, let us know in the comments below.